Hello, welcome to Tales of Xillia 2, part number 7. I'm Matsu, and we're going to go ahead and get started. I haven't really changed much besides my microphone volume, which might be a bit too much. I'm not certain yet, so I'm waiting for someone to confirm or deny the changes. So the last time I played, I was with Leah. I'm actually gonna do something really quick here, because I feel that it is important, because whenever I do a change, like, it's best to actually just test it out, you know? Okay, it looks like my microphone stuff is working fine for now, so I'm gonna keep at it and see how it goes. With that said, let's start with Leah.
Hey, there you are! Are you okay? I saw Drissel while I was out snooping for leads. She said a bunch of Spurious agents have gone missing in action.
Mighty Spurious agents, MIA? Must be one dangerous job.
She thinks a fractured dimension might have something to do with it.
Vera here. We've detected a new fractured dimension, but...
Agents go in, but they don't come out. Am I right?
So you've already heard.
Is it that dangerous?
All I can tell you is that an agent's ability level determines the level of danger. The last communication I received from an agent indicated that the Divergence Catalyst was an extremely powerful monster.
Wonderful.
Stand by for the coordinates of the fractured dimension. The rift is in Bermia Gorge. Do be careful.
I'm coming too. I don't like the sound of this one bit. And I owe you one anyway.
I'll come too. If I didn't, who knows what horrible things our intrepid reporter here would write about me.
Do you have to invent an excuse every time you help someone?
That's a very good question, Leah. All right. So, I'm pretty sure I can actually access that fractured dimension here. Yep. Which is Bermia Gorge. I don't think I've actually been there before. Okay. Yeah, I don't think I have gone here yet. However, this is one of the zones from the first game. Just like everything else within this game, I guess. Well, almost everything
right.
else.
I'm charged and ready. Where you at, Mr. Divergence Catalyst?
I don't think it's quite that simple.
Agria?
You're late, moron!
Ow!
I've been blowing up your phone all day! And why have you got these men with you?
Good to meet you.
Huh? And who is this doofus right here? So Jude dumped you.
And this guy's your rebound? Really now?
What? No!
Whatever. Do you want to write your stupid story about the monster here, or what? About ecosystems and poachers, or whatever. Weird to hear you talk about complicated stuff like that.
Huh?
Hello, your story.
Yeah. And Leia asked us along for backup in case there was any fighting. Right, Leia?
Not a bad idea. Poachers have stuck that damn beast so many times, it's out of its mind.
Right!
Ugh, what an airhead. I'm going on ahead.
What is wrong with her?
Well, we might as well follow her.
Yeah, if we're lucky, maybe she'll lead us to a clue.
So, in the other game, Aguirre didn't actually seem normal. She was always this crazy girl. For her to have this type of a personality is very strange.
Well, I never would have expected this. You and Agria chasing down a story together? What exactly is going on here?
How should I know? I guess we work for the same company in this world? I don't know.
Agria's a journalist? Ooh boy. Although she does seem a lot more pleasant than the Agria from our world.
She was an odd one. It was like she refused to get along with anyone.
It's hard to find the right words.
Anyhow, I never thought I'd see her again. How am I supposed to react to this?
I never thought you'd ask me that. How am I supposed to respond to this?
Hey, don't imitate me.
That sounded just like you.
Oh, come on, you thought that was funny? I don't sound anything like that.
But hey, I still think you need to get out of your head. React naturally. Don't overthink it.
Wait, you were trying to change my mood?
Oh?
Just a gentle push from a mature adult. No need to fall all over yourself thanking me.
Trust me, I won't.
Damn. This part is probably going to be a bit short. The main reason why is because... I feel very tired, and being tired and playing video games is not good, especially video games that actually revolve around the story, because the chances of you actually retaining all of the information is pretty slim, you know. Also, I have new members. Okay, it looks like I'm sure we'd actually do though, so I'm just gonna use the single thing.
Aww, that's it?
That was pretty funny. Jude just kept on spamming palm strike. Palm strike, palm strike, palm strike, palm strike. Another thing that happened besides my microphone changing stuff again is that my capturing device that I use has been changed, meaning that it's been updated to the latest version, which could potentially mean that it might have broken something. I'm not entirely certain, so just giving you a heads up, you know.
Don't treat me like a kid. Just remember, you and I are partners.
You're right, you're right. You're absolutely right, Ellie. I thought that was a bag too. It's just a rock.
Agria seems surprisingly eager to work with you.
Yeah.
Disintegrate! I'll help. Disintegrate!
Who's next?
How too easy.
I'm getting stronger.
I don't know if I've mentioned this yet, but there is a chance that I probably have not said it and I've dreamt it, but I think the reason why she says too easy is maybe because I'm playing this game on easy difficulty, you know what I mean? So like they're just saying it to just say too easy, raise up the difficulty, you know what I mean? Also, this is one of the places where I had a secondary quest to do, which is interesting. So, and this is another one, gentle slip. I don't really know what these things look like, though. But I'm gonna have to fight as many monsters as possible here. So that way I can actually complete this side quest.
This is nothing.
There should be something here, yeah? Ah, there's a chest there. Aha! Is this a rare chance?
Let's be sure to keep this up.
Also, another thing that I'm excited about is that tomorrow I'm gonna get my chair, and by my chair I mean I'm gonna get a new chair.
Damn, Agria, how far did you go?
Which is pretty fantastic. It's called Harmon Miller Aeron, and it's one of the higher end chairs, and they're very comfortable.
Super easy.
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 You copying me?
Maybe.
I love that one. Super easy. A special dude, eh?
Hello there.
Amazing. Hello there.
Guess who just got stronger?
No! What the? What just happened?
Over already?
Let's do our thing.
All right, it's time to see you later.
Awesome.
I bet.
You've gotten stronger.
It's not bad. I definitely need somebody to like confirm this stuff though, man, because kind of because I think that my microphone might be a bit too loud. But then again, I could be also wrong about that, you know. The reason why I constantly change my settings when it comes to streaming stuff is because I want to make it better. And because of that, I'm constantly changing my settings over and over again because I want to make sure that it's actually high quality, you know. Okay,
aww,
thank you, Cypher.
That's it? Death to your debts. The least I can do is get you charged up, right? To be honest, I felt really bad about your whole predicament at first. But if you keep this up, you'll be out of the hole in no time.
You know, what is this?
Vera here. I've got urgent news for you. Former Director Kresnik has stolen the Kanan Waymarker you recovered.
What?
I've also been given a message for you from a man named Erston. It reads, meet me in front of the Spurious building.
The King!
No, let's see what Erston has to say.
Very well. We'll continue to pursue former Director Kresnik and keep you updated on our progress.
That was pretty fascinating. Galleys, huh? That's cool. And just as expected, he was caught on purpose. Looking forward to it, man. I love funny lines. I just need to figure out, like, where am I supposed to go? I think I need to drop down there. Yeah, and then just go this way. I'm also super tired, Cypher, so if I don't sound super enthusiastic, it's primarily because I'm just super tired.
Well, not bad.
You got it. Yes, that's what I'm talking.
Yes, so what I was doing before was that every night. Whoa, okay, she's actually here. I want to clear this area before I go further, though. So I'm just going to fight this guy. But basically, what I was doing was that I was going to actually... I was basically taking a nap each time before I started to actually swim. Which is the reason why I feel super tired right now.
Too easy.
So I'm trying to change that so that way it's a bit
stronger.
So that way I can actually stream for a lot longer and a little earlier as well, because well, you know, so I can actually get through the games much more faster.
So I'm gonna take a wild guess here and say that's the monster. This won't be easy.
It's no surprise the whole ecosystem's out of whack with that thing on the loose. Those damn Olympian poachers really did a number on it. Nothing left to do but put it out of its misery.
The poachers are from Olympias?
Duh! Isn't that what your stupid story is about? Those bloodthirsty Olympian thrill seekers?
How awful.
I hate those Olympians. Eat them to bits, massacring spirits with their spirix like it's no big whoop.
But Maxwell made it so they can keep using their spirix for a while, right?
It's still a fact that spirix kill spirits, and they just put it out of their minds. Just because they're too stupid to channel spirits, they think they're entitled to use their damn spirix. Won't be long before Risa Maxi is a wasteland. Just like Olympias!
But that's why everyone's working so hard on Spyrite technology.
What? You're taking their side now?
It's not like that. It's just, I've seen people in Olympias who are trying really hard to solve these problems. And I want to believe them.
That's who you choose to believe? Huh, you really are the most gullible person alive.
You know, I shouldn't say I had no idea you were so despised, because that's going to actually make things a bit bad. So instead, I'll just say, why don't you trust Olympias?
Seriously? They treat us like we're a bunch of barbarians. Oh, and then there was that time they tried to invade Rizomaxia and turn us into fuel. Remember? Why the hell would anyone ever trust them? What? Have you got a problem with that? Huh? Ow! What the hell?
This is no time to be picking fights. We gotta put that beast down, remember?
Fine. Then I'll handle this myself.
Wait!
Acria!
Alright. Start off strong.
Keep your cool. This is a fractured dimension.
I know that, but that shouldn't matter.
Whoa. I set up through that.
Look out!
Disintegrate!
Let's show him!
No brakes?
Recharge! Falling thunder!
Got your back!
I'll help!
No brakes?
I'm here for you!
Conserve your strength!
Leia, are you gonna be alright?
Yeah.
That's such a useful thing, man. Just going into the chrono trigger. See what I did there?
Man, I feel good.
What happens if we wait a little longer? I'm just curious.
Agria! You okay?
Shut up! Oh! Quit freaking out over every little thing! Did you honestly think that would kill me?
That's no reason to kick me!
Ha! That was payback for earlier.
Oh, thanks.
Tell me something. Do you really trust them? Let's be honest now.
Huh? Oh, yeah. I mean, Olympias is in a tough spot, too. I know that some of them look down on Rizomaxia. But if we really work at it, we can reach a place of mutual trust and respect. Right?
Guess it worked out for you and me. When the Nia Kara Holomont collapsed, you were there and reached out your hand. And thanks to you, I'm still here. Stop grinning like an idiot! Anyway, we're done here. Now it's time for you to do your job. Go home and write your article, Leia.
Well, that's interesting.
And here we thought that would be tough. I barely broke a sweat.
Hey, it's necessary to destroy all those fractured dimensions, right? I mean, we did the right thing, didn't we?
You know, I want to believe that, but I feel that there is a bigger story at play here. So I can't just say we did, because honestly, like, I don't know. Yeah, because we call this the prime dimension, but there are these other worlds there too, which are, you know, connected to our world. So I don't know, you know. Honestly, I want to do that.
Yeah. Luger, you think it'd be okay if I wrote an article about the fractured dimensions? About the people who lived there, and what they were like, and why they needed to be destroyed?
If you did that, I suppose they'd live on, in a way.
You can't write that.
Well, I'm beat. Gonna grab some grub and some shut-eye.
Watch over me, okay?
I mean, she could write a book after this is done, but currently Spyrus, like, the information that she has there is not supposed to be available to the public. So if she actually says,
oh,
hey...
Writing for the paper has made me realize how truly horrible my penmanship is. When I turned in my last article, I could see pity in my editor's eyes. I gotta really practice now.
Yeah, like, she can't do that because Spyrus will be like, nope, you're gone. So, anyways. Alright, Heavy Claw, I don't know. I think that's the guy that I just defeated? I don't know. Damage report completion. Yep. Can you handle this for me? I'd take care of it myself, though. If it were a plain old bee, but a sword bee. That's it. I'm out of here. Alright. I used to do, I took some acting classes at school as well, so I can use that at times. Can you bring me some holy ash? There's been a holy craze among my clients lately. Let's see. Yeah, so I could actually do the voice acting stuff, it's just that... I kind of don't want to be honest, which is part of the reason why. Nice. I can't do this, right? Yeah. Okay, so Bermia. And removes and oh my god, these side quests, man, they're crazy. So how was your game, Cypher? Did you enjoy it? Of course you enjoyed it because you're actually playing it. What kind of question is this? You know. All right, I'm gonna go with this guy. Get them down quick. Okay, so I'm just thinking on what am I supposed to do right now. I guess I'll go and do the main quest now. Because why not, right? Because that's where I'm actually supposed to go, so... Ah, I see. I'm just thinking. Right, in front of the Spyrus Corporation, so this is where I'm supposed to go. I'll just do top. Yeah, that's fine. Oh.
Got nothing.
What's wrong?
You know how budget gourmet food is blowing up right now? I was trying to come up with a few recipe ideas.
You should ask Luger about that. He might have some.
What do you think? Got any ideas for my new budget gourmet menu?
Actually, you know what? Everything's pink might actually go for the ladies.
Everything's pink?
A pink sushi bowl?
Oh, I get it. Make the rice with plum vinegar, top it with shrimp, salmon, garnish with pink ginger.
That sounds so cute! I want one!
Hurry up and get cooking!
Ooh, looks like a hit with the young female demographic.
What if we made it even pinker? Like, with watermelon chunks?
And strawberry mousse!
Let's remember this is a sushi bowl. Don't get crazy with the sweet stuff.
It's about cuteness, not flavor.
Down with your anti-pinkest agenda!
The young female demographic is proving to be a tad challenging. Let's head back to the drawing board.
So, something to note is that Tipo is actually... One sec. My EX is totally becoming such a creeper. He wants to get back with me, but how could I be with someone who can't leave Telegram? Please. is that Tipo is basically released his emotions. And Tipo tends to exert those that way. I think that the term is exert. I'm probably just making that word up, but we'll see. Or I guess we won't see, because I'm not going to stretch it up right now. Too tired for that. Hello. What's up, Ernest? A.K.A. Gallius? I don't actually remember how to pronounce his name right now, too. It's crazy. Gaius. Okay, there we go.
Oh, hey, Hurston. Good news. It looks like your friends finally arrived.
Thanks for the info. Let me know if you hear anything else.
Maybe next time we can chat over drinks.
Sure. First round's on me.
I should have guessed that Gaius was the cause of that hubbub. Oh, right. I was just showing Mila around. She wanted to learn more about Olympias.
You people can't do anything without Spyrex.
You have fun mingling with the locals, Gaius?
Yes. Olympians are really no different from we Risa Maxians, once you get to know them.
Well, don't tell me you buy drinks with taxpayers' money. You said you wanted to speak to me?
Yes, you and one other person. Rowan brought me up to speed with what's been happening. So, you're the former Maxwell.
And you're some sort of big shot? Is that it?
The biggest shot? He's a king, for crying out loud!
Whoop-de-doo! I'm the Lord of Spirits. Beat that.
I must admit, I'm fascinated. So these fractured dimensions undoubtedly do exist. But I digress. Luger, I need to know if you're truly worthy of carrying the fate of the world on your shoulders.
And if I'm not worthy?
Death.
Seems fair enough.
Dying isn't allowed!
How exactly do you want him to prove it?
Bring me into a fractured dimension, so I might see his actions for myself.
Vera here. We've detected a new fractured dimension. The rift is in Canbalar. Please depart for it immediately.
Perfect timing.
I'll come too. I want to watch you end a world.
You know, Luger's been doing a pretty good job out there.
I hope you're right.
So, you probably don't know, but I'm a reporter now. Mind if I whip up a human interest piece on you?
That would completely blow my cover.
Oh, no problem. I won't run it until after you finish your work.
Finishing it could take years.
No worries, I can wait.
In that case, do whatever you deem fit.
Awesome, thank you! This will be the story of a lifetime! But hold on, if you wanted to talk to Luger, why didn't you just call him on his GHS? I can give you his number if you don't have it.
No thanks. Rowan was kind enough to program this, but...
Let me guess. Technology's not exactly your thing.
It's time to show me around one of those fractured dimensions.
Best story ever!
That face.
So kings don't really live in castles, huh?
Well, I'm sure some of them do.
Alright, here we go. Fractured dimension number... Actually, I should probably go and save before we begin. Look at this guy. He's ready to fight. I don't know how much longer I can take. Oh, hey, Jude. How you been? Oh, sorry. Oh, hey, Jude. What's going on? How you been? Man. All right. Oh, Gaius is now in the party? That's awesome. Guys, let's see if I actually have any arts. Ooh. Wait. How do I even use that though? Do we just click in it? I'm not really attacking it or anything.
Don't treat me like a kid. Just remember, you and I are partners.
Ah, I see.
We have
That's
no
cool.
limits.
Of course. I wonder if Gaius is going to become a party member.
These
with
are the Mon Highlands, right?
For the entirety of the game, but I doubt it. Alright, so it was Falling Thunder. I'm actually gonna swap this for Time Descent and Falling Thunder. Okay. And that should be
then
good.
Then our first destination should be Canvalar.
I think this is actually his downtown. Downtown? his hometown. Wow.
Wow, Gaius. You've really managed to adapt yourself to Olympias, huh?
What?
Hey, Erston. You've really managed to adapt yourself to Olympias, huh?
Yes, by posing as the scion of a wealthy family from a remote region of the country. They've taken to calling me the prodigal son down at the docks.
You've developed a whole character for yourself. I had no idea you were such a performer.
What's a prodigal son?
The world is in crisis and you're playing make-believe? Maybe you should take this a little more seriously.
Do you agree with that assessment?
Maybe it's precisely because, you know what? I'm going to go with Gaius on this one.
Indeed. Could a ruler who can't empathize with the lives of the citizenry be trusted in a time of crisis? His ignorance could lead his country to disaster.
A world in crisis means people in crisis. So the more you understand people, the better you can serve them.
So you understand.
As a journalist, I represent the common man.
His Highness really is a great man.
Al, you're not supposed to call him that.
Oh, his prodigal Highness really is a great man.
Wow. Well, something to note is that Mila is actually is actually Jude's thing in a sense. So like Mila and Jude are, you know, are meant to be together. So which is the reason why I actually chose that option.
What are you looking at?
Oh, I was merely noticing the differences between your hairstyle and Prime Mila's.
What's Prime Mila's hair like?
How can I explain it? Locks of hair sort of pop out of the left side of her head.
That's like how a child would describe it. You sure are ignorant about these things.
The topic does not come up often in my political and military planning meetings.
She probably has self-style it for her. I used to do that too, but maintaining it was such a hassle. Although when I swung it around quickly, I could distract a foe between attacks.
So that's what it was for.
I know what you mean. If my hair isn't parted straight down the middle, it drives me crazy. But it's such a pain trying to get it to stay that way.
Oh, do you do your own hair?
No, my daddy used to do it for me.
And now?
Now I have Luger do it.
Then isn't he the one who should be complaining about it?
Well, it's a pain to have to hold still for so long.
I didn't think you were all that special when I first met you. But you do seem to know what you're doing out there. Here, I'll give you this. It would just weigh me down anyway.
Thank you. I don't know what did you give me, but... Oh, you gave me instant landing. Fantastic. Can't wait to use it. If I go back, I'm actually gonna get out of this region, so I just have to keep on going in the front. Also, the enemies look a lot more scary now, which is cool.
You're no match for me.
I must become stronger.
Yeah, Gaius is a pretty cool character. He almost actually became Maxwell, which is the Lord of Spirits, in order to actually, I guess, save the world? At least that's what I think he was doing. I don't actually remember entirely, to be honest.
Hey, Your Highness, you know when it's super cold and you get those weird bumps on your skin? Why is that?
Because it's cold.
That's great. Hey, Exodus people are here, huh?
Be gone!
I haven't fought them in a long time.
Very well done.
Let's be sure to keep this up. You guns,
hey!
We have no limits.
I think this is a regular dude. I'm not gonna fight him. It's not worth my time. No! Why do you guys make these caves with nothing in them? It's like a literal waste of time. There are actually two ways to get to a specific area. So I'm gonna make a mental note of making sure to edit my save the next time I actually start playing this game. So yeah, I'm gonna get that done. So earlier in the day tomorrow, I'm going to be streaming the editing of this game, so that way this would give you a bit more perspective on the type of things that steps that you would need to take in order to edit, you know, games, and editing other PlayStation 3 games works in a similar manner. So if you wanted to do something like that, you'll be able to do that easily that way, you know. So I'll do that most likely earlier tomorrow.
So this is a fractured dimension.
Waymarker response detected. Commence retrieval.
There's a waymarker here.
What do we do?
First, we try to find the thing that sticks out the most from the prime dimension. That's usually the catalyst.
Isn't this your hometown? Notice anything unusual?
It's as if there's a pall in the air.
Well, the first step in reporting is to ask around.
Why do these foes undulate like that? I find them quite disturbing.
The chimera.
It's freezing! Why does it have to be so cold here?
You can warm yourself by conserving the energy you use, flapping your tongue, and use it to move your body instead.
Must you always say such tedious things in such a tedious way?
Then your tedious grumbling makes us two of a kind.
You really are a delight. I'm guessing you don't have many friends, huh?
Friends? Indeed I do not.
That's not true. Weren't the Chimeriad your friends?
It's been a while since I've heard that name.
I don't know what that is, but it sounds cool.
Wingle, Agria, Zhao, and Pressa. They were Gaius's bodyguards, and they were all super powerful warriors.
So where are they now? I know that they were all defeated and died.
Yeah, about that.
They aren't anywhere. They're all dead.
Oh.
Oh no.
It was during the war when they opened the schism. We were involved, too.
There's no need for you to feel responsible. Wingle, Zhao, Pressa, and Agria gave their own lives so that I could move forward with mine. The responsibility for their sacrifices rests solely with me, and I will not dishonor them by compromising my goals. That is all you need to know.
Right.
Cold.
Is it? I find it quite refreshing for this time of year.
No way! There is no way it gets colder than this! Back me up on this, Luger!
It's not so bad, right? Of course I'm gonna back you up. No, I'm not. I'm gonna back Gaius up.
Indeed. I hardly even need a coat.
Are you crazy? You'll catch a cold.
Once you've acclimated to the weather, you'll have no such concerns. When I was in my 20s, I'd walk down this street in short sleeves with a pound of ice cream.
What?
People can get used to anything. But you already seem quite tolerant of the cold, Luger. Perhaps you are ready to embark on a special journey. I crafted an igloo outside of the city, my secret fortress of icy solitude. It has a spectacular view. It's one of the many places that are truly special to Kanbalar.
Wow, His Highness is really something.
There is something I wish you to have. It is of no great value, but I believe you'll put it to good use. Take it.
So it's funny, I'm finding myself choosing options which actually help specific, well not help, but increase the affinity of specific party members, even though I shouldn't play the game like that, but because I know that type of choice is there, I'm just picking the one which would actually benefit me like more. Which is kind of, I guess, strange because I don't know. It's kind of weird how like I am, I guess, min-maxing my my choices within this game because of the fact that I know that I'm going to get more benefits by choosing another choice. You know what I mean? It's kind of silly. And I actually picked that habit up from playing World of Warcraft and raiding hardcore. Which pretty much means that I spent a lot of time just playing World of Warcraft, so it's pretty crazy. Yeah, and in that one, like, you have to min-max everything, and that's the reason why I have the habit of doing that within games. Ah, I see. Well, that's good. I am happy that that's actually there. So, at a certain point, when I was actually doing the whole dialogue thing, there was a point where Gaius actually mentioned his comrades.
The me of this world has already abdicated the throne. So this is what a fractured dimension is like.
So sometimes your party members isn't the better choice. I see. Interesting. Okay. All right. Well, I'll pick the one that's the better, or that I feel is the better choice. Well, the reason why I was doing it, because it actually increases the affinity, right? So, I don't know. But basically, those four people that they actually mentioned were actually his friends. And in Tales of Xillia, you actually end up fighting all of them and defeating them, and then you fight Gaius. It's that game has a lot of content when compared to this game so far, from my experience at least. Okay, this is the wrong way. I actually don't know where am I going. I knew. Okay. I see. Okay. So that was a way to get up there. I don't actually remember how to navigate this town. It has been a very long time. But I think that I have to go here to progress further. Once again, I would talk to a lot of these people. Everyone who disobeyed the king is dead. This is why I must obey him. Interesting. So the new king is actually not very good to his people.
Can't say I like the looks of that. Not one bit.
I don't know if we're gonna get through this way.
Wow. Okay, so the king here has changed quite a lot of stuff. Dude, that's crazy. Okay, so guys, just in case you were not paying attention. One sec. King Wingle has no need for opinions of those beneath him. I see. Interesting. So, pretty much, what happened here is, in this one, Gaius is not a king within I guess, city? Country? I'm not sure what you want to call it. And instead, there's another one. And the people here are all pretty bad people from the looks of it. So, this should be pretty interesting.
Disperse. The castle is off limits by order of His Highness King Li Ying himself.
Should I turn back? I mean, forcing my way in will not work well. in this scenario. Turning back is the best option.
Just go home. Nothing good can come from meeting with His Highness anyway.
I guess I have to force my way in then.
Disperse. You shall not pass. If I fail in my duties, he'll kill me too.
You know, it would have been awesome if they actually used a line, "You shall not pass," you know, but I guess it's been copyrighted or something.
I figured as much.
There is another way we get the rooftop. I see. Well,
this is the result of
it is too late now.
This city is as tedious as it is annoying.
The real thing is actually quite nice, really.
Technically, I killed those guys mercilessly because I could have found the other way, but instead I chose to just... I see. Interesting. Well, I don't really mind. It's going to give me more experience points, but morally, I think that if I was in this situation, like let's say that this was happening in real life and I was a protagonist and all that stuff, and I would choose the other way because likely chances those guards that I just killed had families, had friends, had like a life outside of just being a guard, right? And now that's all gone because I decided to just kill them and be and just say I don't want to deal with this, you know what I mean? But if that was the case, which, you know, which we can actually assume it was, I should have chosen the other path. So this actually makes me a bad person. And by me, I mean Luger. Anyways, you know, that's something that a lot of people don't think about, especially.
What's going on here? It's deserted.
Has the current king become a complete recluse?
Especially when it comes to actually killing things, or I guess killing people. Like, a lot of people forget the fact that the people that actually died are, you know, have,
kings,
you know, have families
solitude.
Or friends. Yeah, I don't know. I'll talk more about it later.
It wasn't supposed to be like this. This is wrong. Why do you vex me so? Who are you people?
Winkle?
More would-be assassins vying for my head. Rest assured. No guards shall fly to my rescue. I'm a lonely king who deserves to die. But first, I will make you rue the moment you dare to set foot in my throne room.
Now he talks in like crazy stuff. But I just want to talk to you.
Agreed. This world is but one outcome. Perhaps this is the bitter fruit born from a mistake of my own making. Mian Li Ying.
Bai Yal Ti Din Yuai Kairo Din Yin Der Kuraya Lin Yal Yo Din
Jibiti Yayo Li Ying Ki Wung Tin
Erston? Erston, you came back. Please, Erston, try to forgive me.
What happened?
Must you make me say it?
It started when you began talking about abdicating the throne and abandoning your people.
Why would Gaius do that?
Carla was fading. You wanted to be with her at the end.
Carla, her illness.
Who's Carla?
Gaius's little sister.
I know that once you make a decision, you never waver in it. So I begged Carla to help you refocus your attention on your kingly duties. She agreed to help, but I never thought that she would.
To prevent me from going through with abdicating, she took her own life.
Erston, forgive me! I never dreamed that would happen. You must believe me, please!
Her death broke this world's Gaius, and he left the public eye forever.
What? You're not Erston!
I'm not the Erston you know, that much is true. But believe me, I understand how he must have felt.
But your tongue! Erston Outway was my only true friend! You could never understand him!
So the possibility existed for us to be friends.
Clearly he didn't feel the same about me. Erston abandoned me along with his people! Why? Damn it, Erston! Tell me why!
He's the catalyst!
Luger didn't even need to help this time.
Are you really up for this, Gaius?
This brutality is what it takes to destroy a world, right? How can I presume to judge Luger without first having walked a mile in his shoes? Now!
I believe Wingo was one of his friends as well.
So this is the Divergence Catalyst.
This one's different from my sister.
He's using a booster! This guy's scary! Do something!
Phalanx! Now it's this! Flame charge!
And this guy, when he actually transforms, he starts speaking Chinese from all of the time. But I could be ignorant in that fact in saying that, because he could not be speaking Chinese.
Things in moderation.
You okay with this?
I do what must be done.
Figures you'd say that.
I must become stronger.
Erston, save me, please!
To sit upon that throne means embracing the needs of the many and forsaking the needs of the one. To rule is to accept a lonely life. A king must discard his own sense of self.
It was too much for me.
Indeed. Luger, I leave the rest to you.
Well, Gaius has, as Wingle actually mentioned, Gaius, whenever he makes a decision, that is his final decision, which means that I'm just going to do that instead of saying, are you sure?
Ah!
done.
Hey, it's a V-Marker. I'm sure Julius will show himself pretty soon.
Job back there. So that was a fractured dimension. It's true. I spent many sleepless nights wondering whether I should abdicate the throne for Carla's sake. But when it was all said and done, I chose to remain king. Do you know why?
Because you're strong. I don't think it's because you like ruling. You know that ruling is a part of it, but because you're strong would be the way to go.
Because I'm strong, huh? Whatever strength I had was derived from those who supported me. Those like the Chimeriad, among others. They made the isolation bearable. I couldn't just take my leave of them. Mark my words, Luger. There's a lesson for you in this. Destroying worlds requires a sense of detachment, one that will corrode the strongest of souls. If you continue to fight on your own, the isolation will consume you someday.
Isolation means being alone, right? So there's no problem, because Luger's got all of us.
That's big talk from a little girl.
Talking is my specialty.
You know, Gaius, they say the more the merrier about a lot of things. Including support.
I suppose you're right. Feel free to call on me if you ever need help. Or if you just feel like grabbing a drink.
Whoa, nicely done, Luger. It's not every day you become drinking buddies with a king.
You picking up the tab?
No, we'll split the bill evenly.
Guess you're not that close of a buddy.
Man, I'll be an old lady before I can finally publish this story about Gaius.
Yeah, that reaction was pretty surprising to me as well. I'm like, whoa, that's great. You okay with that?
Guess I gotta be. He's not the easiest guy to read, but I know there's a lot going on in that head of his. If I put in the time and effort, I know I'll figure out what makes Gaius tick eventually. Kinda the same with you. But don't worry, I'm not gonna write some trashy tell-all, you know.
Alright, that was cool. I actually had a scene with Gaius, which is fantastic. Next story is unlocked with the pay depth again.
Great job, Lutz. You've been cleared to travel to Lacudum Sea Haven. We're thrilled to see you keeping up with the payments. You know what they say. Everyone admires a dependable man.
My daddy said that too. He said I better marry someone dependable or he won't give his blessing.
Then again, if a guy's just Mr. Dependable all the time, it's welcome to Dullsville, population U.
Reliable, but somehow exciting. That must be the key.
Exactly.
Okay.
Hey, I like your clothes. Looks like you and I see eye to eye when it comes to fashion.
Just to be clear, I have no intention of growing a beard.
Hey, hey, hey! You hear the news about the Shandu Coliseum? They're signing up fighters for tag battles now. Bet there's a sweet purse at stake. Hint, hint.
It sure is a relief to have you around at times like this. This would be a lot harder without your support. So, here. It's my way of saying thanks for, you know... Oh, just take it already. When you're around, I have to admit, it puts me so at ease I could just doze right off.
But I gotta stay up late working on my article.
Why did you do this to me, game? He yawned. This is really bad. Alright. Okay. So. Gaius is in my party right now, but I actually want to swap up or change up the party here really quick. Instead of having Mila, I can have her here. And I can have Jude and Gaius. I think Gaius is a useful dude. Because of the fact that he was a pretty big part of the previous game. So this is going to be my new party. Which means I actually need to equip some items for Gaius. And it's pretty neat that I can actually use him. It's awesome. Okay. That's it. I think I also need to actually equip an Allium Orb on him. Ah, yes, of course. Which is great. That's like passive damage as well, so that's fantastic. What does he do? Light element? Okay. So something that does light and something else is what I want. The darkness, wind darkness. You know what? I'm gonna take Mila's and I'm just gonna put it on him instead. Yeah, that's much better. Alright, I want to see if there's any side quests that I can do. Okay, there is a side quest, one. Is there another one in Reach the Maxia? Okay, a couple of them actually. Alright. I don't know if you can tell, but I'm actually having a very difficult time staying awake. And by that, I mean that I'm constantly like just falling asleep on my chair. I think that it would be best for me to call it here. I know that it's like very early for me, considering in majority of the cases, I usually end it at like... at like 6 a.m. so sometimes 6:30 a.m. But today I have to end it a little bit early. Like I really cannot focus really well. It's taking requiring me a great amount of concentration to continue this, so I'm gonna call it here. This is a pretty short part. One of these days I'm gonna like do like a longer stream. I just don't know when that is. Anyways, thank you for watching and have a good day and a good night, and I'll see you next time. Hasta la vista. And next time I'll do these side quests and actually make the payment and stuff too, which should be pretty cool. So, but that's it. Thanks for watching and have a good day. Hasta la vista. Later, man.